Hello everyone. Today's topic of discussion in the subject Internet Programming is Website Basics. I am Mrs. P. Manaka, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Information Technology, Dr. N.G.P. Arts and Science College. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about what is website, World Wide Web and the web, and what is web server and client, what is protocol, and what are all the website types, then static versus dynamic website. So web is nothing but a complex system of interconnected elements, and World Wide Web, which is an information system where documents and other web resources are identified by URLs. A website is nothing but collection of web pages. A web page is a hypertext document connected to the World Wide Web. Again, so World Wide Web, which is also called as the web, the world of computer network. Hyperlinks. So this is a link from a hypertext document to another location, and which is activated by clicking on a highlighted word or image. Hypertext allows the user to select a word or phrase from text and thereby access other documents. Hypermedia. So these are all document feature links to images, sounds, animations, and also movies. Web server. So a server is nothing but a provider of services. The main function of a web server is to store, process, and deliver web pages to clients. Web client, which is nothing but consumer of services, which is nothing but an application that communicates with a web server using a HTTP, that is Hypertext Transfer Protocol. Web browser. So we all came across many web browsers. So a web browser is a software application for accessing information on the World Wide Web. So some of the web browsers are Mozilla Firefox, Google Chrome, Internet Explorer, Apple Safari, and Opera. And let us see about protocol. A protocol is nothing but a set of rules or procedures for transmitting or transfer data between electronic devices such as computers. HTTP, which is an application layer protocol for transmitting hypermedia documents such as HTML. URL. So URL stands for Uniform Resource Locator. So which is nothing but an address to reach a web page. So it is used to specify addresses on the World Wide Web. So whatever the data is stored in the World Wide Web, every data has an address. That is, the data is stored as web pages, each of which has a URL. And some of the websites are dedicated to a particular purpose, like news channels. Say for example, so we have news channels. Say for example, we have BBC, Dinamalar, and Hindu. And for education purpose, we have EDX, Academic Earth, and Big Think. So these particular websites are dedicated for educational only. And for commercial, for business or shopping, we have Amazon, Flipkart, and eBay. And for entertainment purpose, we are familiar with the Crackle, YouTube and Netflix. So for social networking, we have Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. So these are the websites. They are specifically used for certain purposes like news or education or commercial or any entertainment and social networking. So similarly, we have different types of websites. So one can create a personal website for his own work. Say for example, so this is the personal website of ex-US President Mr. Donald Trump. So anyone can create their own personal website. And in case of corporate, any corporate companies can create, like Wipro or Infosys or TCS, they can create, they are having their own websites. And for government purpose, different websites are available, like UPSC exams, TNPSC exams, TRB, Postal Department. So the recent website of government is COVID-19 Management Portal, which is widely used nowadays. And for organizational purpose, here Dr. NGP Arts and Science College has a separate website. And let us see about the basic, that is static and dynamic website. Static website, so the contents are not changed frequently. Once the content is updated, it won't be changed frequently. So you can get the same data forever. And there is no database involved in static websites. Where in the case of dynamic websites, we have databases and the data are frequently updated. So mostly we are using dynamic websites nowadays. So these are the main two different websites. One is static and the other is dynamic. So let us see the difference between static website and dynamic website. So static websites are pre-built content. They have the data which is already stored, and this is same whenever the page is loaded. And in this case of dynamic website, the content is generated quickly and changes regularly. And this static website uses HTML code for developing a website. And this dynamic website, which uses the server-side languages such as PHP, Servlet, JSP and ASP.NET for developing a website. And in case of static websites, it sends exactly the same response for every request because the content is static. But in this case of a dynamic website, it may generate different HTML for each request. And in this case of dynamic website, the page contains server-side code which allows the server to generate the unique content when the page is loaded. So the dynamic gives the unique content only. Whereas in static, the content is only changed when someone publishes and updates the file. And in this static website, flexibility is the main advantage of static website. And in the case of dynamic website, content management system is the main advantage of dynamic website. That is, every time the contents are updated. That is, frequently the contents are updated in this dynamic website. So in a nutshell, we have learned what is website, the concept of web server and client, and then the different types of websites, static versus dynamic websites. Thank you.